这一次要讲的题目是《Silence on the Border》，Resurrection Man，是 Ian McNamee 写的哈。那在介绍这一部作品之前呢，我想先从这个，因为这部作品是这个，它的 genre 是 thrillers 啊，是这个惊恐小说哈。那我想先从这个惊恐小说跟北爱之间的关系切入哈。那这个 Eamon Hughes 在一部论文集《Culture and Politics in Northern Ireland》里面呢，有提到说，其实北爱里面呢，有这个北爱文学里面呢，这个 thrillers 其实算是非常重要的一个文类哈。那他从这个 genre 的特色入手哈，说这个文类呢，其实是非常适合来书写北爱的啊，特别是这个 The Troubles 这段时期。那他从这个 thrillers 的特色是什么呢？我就先把这个 quote 念一次哈。The thriller moves to a closure which project its locale as a closed but always unresolved system。就是一个很封闭的地方，但是这个封闭的地方呢，它是永远有这种无法解决的问题，像是这个 The Cold War can never end, the forces of corruption can never be defeated, and the problems of Northern Ireland will inevitably endure。OK，所以这个 thriller 的特色呢是非常适合用来写这个北爱。好，那在另外一部作一个论文里面呢，《The Thriller in Northern Ireland》这个 Aaron Kelly 他也有提到哈，说这不是说主人提出哈，就是事实上呢，如果去统展品呢，基本就是在2000之前哈，2000年一直到2000年左右呢，一共有400 的作品出哈，然后呢，他们真的去写这个北爱的这些动荡不安的情况哈。好，那接着呢，因为这部作品的作者是 Ian McNamee 哈，那我稍微介绍一下这个作者哈，他是在北爱一个小镇出生的哈，然后呢，他另外一个三部曲哈也是非常知名的。那这部作品《Resurrection Man》呢，它事实上有翻拍成电影哈，那也是由这个 Ian McNamee 去参与撰写的。那在 YouTube 上面可以找到哈，我有看过，但是我觉得其实还好，还是读小说比较有趣哈。那这部作品呢，其实是based on true story 哈，就是真的是发生在北爱的一个案件哈。那他是根据这个 Martin Dillon 他所写的这个记者哈，有点是报道文学的这个 case，然后去发展出这部作品的哈。他的这个报道文学叫做《The Shankill Butchers: The Case Study of Mass Murder》哈，那它是根据一个算是一个帮派哈，就是 Shankill Butchers 哈，那他们在1970年代呢，就是发迹于这个 Shankill Road 哈，然后呢在上面呢，就是基于他们这个宗教上的仇恨哈，然后开始滥杀无辜哈，然后估计呢约有至少23个受害者哈，那他们后来被冠以这个 The Shankill Butchers 的名号哈，那这个 gang 它的这个主要的领导人呢就是这个 Lenny Murphy，然后我们再看一下一些相关的段落哈。As soon as he walked in the bar。Walked in, he knew he was going to be singled out. He had trouble summoning the correct responses. It was a question of assembling an identity out of names, the name of school attended, the name of the street where you lived, your own name. These were the finely tuned instruments of survival. OK，好，所以就呼应到刚才的，讲到 naming 这一件事情哈。然后这里呢是 Victor 哈，他在犯案之后呢。巡视所谓他的城市哈，He was driving carefully along the edges of Catholic Wales, West Belfast. She 就是小说里面他的算是女朋友哈，She had never been this close before, although she had seen these places on television, Ballymurphy, Anderson's Town, the Falls Road。 Names resonant with exclusion. Now they were circling the boundaries, close enough to set foot in them. Victor drove up into foothills until they were looking down on the west of the city. He described how you could wipe them off the map from here. Artillery fire directed with precision, repeated sorties. She could feel his excitement at the idea. 所以呢，Kaylee 这一家无法被，就是他们无法安身立命。换句话说，他们无法在这个 Protestant community 里面找到他们的位置。那 Victor 为了要去改变这个事实，所以他开始犯案。他希望借由犯案呢，能够去一方面去宣称宣告他的 identity。换句话说，他会变得比 Protestant 还要 Protestant。然后一方面呢，借由他的犯案呢，他自己觉得，他是在改写这个 Belfast 的这个地图。好，然后这是两个 journalist 啊，这个 Ryan and Collinger， 他的就是 Ryan 的同事哈，他们走在路上的时候的一些经历哈，那也传达出当时 Belfast 的一个氛围哈。At the bottom of Donegal Pass, they were stopped by an army foot patrol. One of the soldiers asked for their names and addresses and their destination. The others crouched in doorways scanning the rooftops, their faces doubtful as if the buildings themselves, the form and structure of the city were untrustworthy, possessed of a dubious topography which required constant surveillance. 他们不只是被另外一个族群所凝视或者是怀疑哈，然后另外一方面呢，也要面对这个英国当时的一个比如说警力或者是军方的这个 surveillance 哈。好，然后呢，这是这个应该是 Collinger 哈 ，Collinger 他讲这个 Belfast 的生活哈。Inhabitants of the city were adept at deciphering the clues to religion and status contained in an address. Sectarian killers worked on that basis, picking up their victims according to the street they live in. Your address was a thing to be guarded as if the words themselves possessed secret talismanic properties. Your name was replete with power and hidden malevolence. Okay, 好，所以就是说北爱的这些居民呢，好像都很会去解题哈，或者是解码破译等等哈，解码这些充斥的密码哈，说你的姓名是哪里，你住在哪里哈，从这些密码当中去推敲对方的一个族群哈。OK， 然后再来，这也是一个相关的段落哈。He also began to sense that somehow knowledge of this man constituted dangerous information not to be entrusted to words. It had to be conveyed in cautious silences and significant looks. He knew that this silence was the great gift of the city, an enduring monument shaped in a mute effort of years. 这一段是在讲说，就是一连串的这个 Victor 犯案之后呢，这个 community 呈现出来的反而是大家都不太敢讲哈，不太敢讨论这些案件哈。然后那这种 silence 呢，就传达出说，这些群体好像陷入一种恐惧当中哈。然后这些恐惧呢，让他们陷入沉默哈，不敢去谈论这样。